Welcome back to Proactive. I'm delighted to be joined now by Claire Bay, who's an Executive Director at Oriole Resources, and she's going to be talking to us about an exploration update at the Central License Package in Cameroon. Claire, great to have you on. Perhaps you'd like to start by giving us the highlights.
Thanks, Tom. For those that aren't so familiar with the company, the CLP project is a district-scale package of 9 contiguous licenses in central Cameroon. And since 2021, we've been exploring for gold at 5 of those licenses, which we refer to as the Eastern CLP. Late last year, we identified multiple multi-kilometre gold and soil anomalies, including the most substantial one at Umbe, which was extending over 12 and a half kilometres within a 3 kilometre wide corridor. Those results within that corridor delivered up to 838 parts per billion, or in other words, 0.3 grams per tonne gold, which is an excellent result for soil data. Today's results relate to follow-up mapping and selective rock chip sampling of outcrops within that corridor, which has delivered up to 134 grams per tonne gold. And 7 of the 47 samples are graded over a gram per tonne gold. So obviously we're delighted with those results. The veins themselves are brecciated, sulfide rich, they've got boxwork textures after pyrite. So all the things that you'd expect to see in high grading samples. And importantly, we're also seeing that the granite host rocks appear to be mineralized too, which is very, very encouraging. The veins and the granites themselves outcrop over a substantial area of at least 3 kilometres long by 70 metres wide, and so offer an early indication as to the potential scale of the system that we're looking at here at Umbe. And as I say, this is just one of a number of anomalies that we've already identified within the package.
Fantastic. Thanks, Claire. Now, you have talked a little bit about the gold there, but let's get some more information about the lithium at CLP.
Yes, the potential for lithium came about through a routine review of our Eastern CLP stream and soil multi-element data. It identified the potential for lithium at the Undom license, which the regional geology suggested was it could be related to the granites within the package. And so on the basis of that knowledge and association, late last year we were also able to secure the Gambuku license immediately to the south of Undom, as it covers the direct extension of those granitic units. And so since then, the team has been completing a ground truthing exercise across both licenses to assess their potential to host pegmatites within the granites. That's a lithium-bearing rock. It is commonly associated with pegmatites. And so the work has really, to date, has included mapping and taking rock chip sampling across those rock types. Gold very much remains a primary focus for us, but we're certainly not going to pass up the opportunity to investigate other high-value commodities within the CLP if they present themselves to us.
Great stuff. Thanks, Claire. Now, plenty of information there has been shared about what's been going on, but what does it actually mean in practice for the project and for its next steps?
Well, essentially, the results endorse all of the targeting work that we've done to date at the CLP, from the point where we sat down and did a desktop review to select the licenses, right through to our systematic exploration programs. At our Bimini project in northern Cameroon, we identified similar high-grading rock chip samples early on, and just last year reported a 305,000-ounce inferred gold resource grading over 2 grams per tonne. That maiden resource has the potential to grow significantly as we undertake infill and step-out drilling and also work up other prospects on the licence. And so with the results to date at Umbe, we don't really need that much imagination to see the same scenario playing out here and elsewhere within the package. The next steps for us really are to undertake a ground-based geophysics program at the Umbe anomaly to test the vein structures at depth and help us to develop the geological model towards drill targeting, which we are planning to have those drill holes targeted later this year. And in the meantime, we'll also be working up the other anomalies with the Eastern CLP and continuing our lithium targeting at Undom and Gambuku.
Plenty for you to be getting on with then, Claire. I'll let you get back to it, but thank you very much for joining me today on Proactive.
Thanks, Tom.